All right, welcome back, RamFam. We had some major technical difficulties there, but we are back here for the second period. 15:51 left in this one right now in period two, and the Rangers lead this one 1-0 right now. Good period by the Rams defensively, and really just one sneaking by Duke is the difference here so far. And just so y'all know, we have Nita Buckley back with us tonight on the camera, so you can thank her for the fabulous view that you're getting right now, with the exception of this wall, which Nita did not design. This wall block in the near side corner in the Rams offensive zone this period might be a little obstructive at times. We'll do our best to let you know what's happening. Difficult for me to see around it. Well, point blank shot from Miller right from the low slot. Well defended and turned away by the Rangers goalie. Kept in by Landy at the point and poked out by the Rangers. Costa back to pick this one up, and the Rams playing a little bit tighter defensively so far in this period. Costa sends that puck forward and brings the forecheck pressure with Miller in right behind him. He picks up the puck and heads to the near side corner. He's checked hard there. Back to the point is Culp. Deflection try by Miller. And picked up by the Rangers behind their net. Culp again sends it in deep off the glass. And behind the net, the Ranger picks it up. Picked off by Costa. And again, more physical and aggressive play from the Rams. Ranger skated in onside. Saved by Pingree, and he covers it up. Am I talking for no reason? Maybe, maybe not. All right, Rams take the faceoff in their defensive zone. Picked up by the Rangers and then poked away by Melnick. Melnick sends it back behind the net where it's picked up by Denis. Denis skates over to the near side boards, avoids a check by the Rangers, and skates away. Matheny back to Denis. Denis to center ice. Back to Denis. Caleb Steele. Steele. Oh, and Denis almost got caught with his head down on that play. He was looking for the puck in his feet as a Ranger came in and tried to take him out. Lucky to get away with that one. That could have been a dangerous play. So we'll have we had an offside play there as Denis got that puck caught up in his feet and it was poked in offside. So faceoff just outside the Rams offensive zone going to be taken by Komorowski. Komorowski sent it to the near side board. Matheny in support there along with, oh, it's Komorowski again. Sent in on net, gloved by Duke. Duke's going to pause on this one rather than hand it off to a teammate as there was some forecheck pressure coming from the Rangers. Face-off won cleanly by the Rangers. They sent it from the right point back in deep. Melnick back defending and working for that puck sent. Back behind Duke and then a shot. He covers it up with the glove. So, puck in the Rams defensive zone here. Hammerquist goes after it, centers it to the blue line. No one there but a Ranger who picks it up. Cross ice pass. Back into the corner. Picked up again by the Rangers at the far side point. And, point blank shot from the middle of the right circle. And that wrister goes right in on Pingree. Again, I believe that one was stick side. Just like the first goal, so 2-0 Rangers, 13:16 left in the second. Rams are going to have to work on creating some offense as well as firming up the defensive side because that Ranger was standing wide open. between the slot and the far circle. Played out by Pingree on the stick of Culp. Culp passes it over to Patterson. Patterson misses the connection with that one, and some sloppy passing by the Rams creates a little pressure for the Rangers. They can't control it, and so the Rangers take over here and bring it into the zone cleanly. Going to be a centering attempt here right in front. Back to the point. Big shot, deflection right in front of Pingree. That one goes just wide.
Sam Sarver. And number 11, Andre Lemire.
No, you're done. It's drained.
It's dead?
Yep.
All right, folks. I think I'm back here. Lost a battery on a mic pod. Tonight's just technical difficulties. We apologize. Rams defending now in their zone. Pass through the slot. Doesn't connect with a Ranger. And the Rams have it back on their stick and are headed back the other way. It's Landon Miller forward with it. Keeps it in the zone. Sorry, Landon Bandico, hard check behind the boards. And this game is getting a little chippy. We have a penalty. Looks like it's gonna be on the Rangers here, so the Rams will go on the power play. At 11:33 here, remaining in the second, the Rams will get an opportunity with the extra man. Again, an offensive faceoff chance for the Rams, and with the extra attacker, hopefully they can turn this into something to notch on the scoreboard and get back in this one a little bit. He and Benito wins the faceoff. Komoski back to fight for it. Goes to Ian Hammerquist. Hammerquist with the left-handed shot right in. And a shot to the head after the whistle by the Lewis Palmer player. There was a little poke check after the Rangers goaltender swallowed that puck up, and Komorowski kind of shoved his stick in there, so he's going to go to the box now. It's going to be matching penalties for the shot to the head and the poke after the whistle. So this one will stay to the Rams' advantage. 5-on-4, as those penalties will match. Rams win the faceoff. Kept in by Denis, and a shot goes wide. Daniels back to Costa. Across to Hammerquist. Hammerquist skating with it. Hits the brakes, and his man flies by. Back to Denis. Cross ice pass to Bendico, who's in onside. He's going to take a shot. Just wide left there. Bendico's shot. Sorry, that's Key and Bendico. Just to keep the Bendicos straight tonight. And another shot in. And that puck's still loose in front. Yeah, good try by the Rams. And that puck is cleared out. It's bobbling towards Pingree. Pingree settles it down. Sends it back out to the near side boards here. He and Bendico with the puck. Reverses it back to Hammerquist. Hammerquist up off the glass and into the zone. Down into the near side corner. And Daniels goes down, along with his Ranger defender. Some hard checking happening around. This game's getting very physical. Kept in at the line by Melnick. Melnick punches it back in deep. Kian Bendico reverses that. And the Rangers wind up clearing it. About 50, I can't tell, the board here is tricky to read. I think 35 seconds left on this power play for the Rams. Some of the lights are out on the scoreboard, and you can't see the numbers accurately, so I apologize. And the puck's cleared again. The Rams will retreat for it. That looks like 15 seconds left on this power play.
That's so bad.
So now the teams are at even strength with Komorowski. Miller lays a hit on his man. Puck back to the blue line. Cross ice pass for Landy. Landy looking for the tip in front.
It's a goal!
Rams goal. As Nick Landy takes a shot from the right point. And it's deflected in front. I'm not sure who gets credit for that one. So the Rams are on the board with 9:19 left in the second here. And that goal was desperately needed. So they are officially on the board and things are underway here. We're looking for more of that type of pressure. And that was an even strength goal because the Rangers had just gotten their man out of the box. Rangers in, poked by Kian Bendico back behind the end boards. Deep by Hammerquist as he goes through the zone, sends it in deep. Komorowski giving chase. He's in, centering pass right in front. Oh, couldn't connect with Hammerquist there. Rangers look to exit, but picked up by Gavin Costa. Gavin goes in on the left wing. He's taken out hard by the Ranger player. And back to the end boards. So that was an icing call, I believe. And we'll have a face-off in the Rams offensive zone again. Good opportunities here when you get these offensive zone face-offs. As hard as the Rams have been kind of back on their heels with the pressure from the Rangers tonight, you want to take advantage of these opportunities. Pass looked to be centered there, and it's picked up by a Ranger and sent back, and this is going to be a penalty on Rampart. I believe there was a slash over in the Rams offensive zone. One of the Rangers players lost his stick, and Matheny's going to head to the box for 2 minutes. I won't repeat what Nita is saying behind me, but she didn't like the call. I think it was a slash here. I don't know. I didn't. So Rams go on the PK here for the next 2 minutes. 8:29 left in the second period. And Sean Melnick with heavy pressure on the offenseman trying to work this puck back behind Pingree. Along with Komorowski, very active stick there from Blake. The captain over defending on the near side corner. Puck back at the blue line and then sent in. Centering try right in front of Pingree, and that puck bounces out safely to the corner. With Melnick again checking his man into the corner boards, and he comes away with the puck. Sean Melnick had it on his stick for a moment. It's poked right back and then on the stick of a Ranger back at the right blue line. And that puck finally cleared out by Rampart as Komorowski chases it down. He's tripped up near the blue line. The Rangers goalie kind of tosses his stick and looks for a penalty on Komorowski, and the ref shakes his head. Nope, not going to happen. Saw it the whole way. Glove saved by Pingree. On a low slot try by the Rangers. It was a good shot attempt there and a great save by Adu. Rams wind up with this faceoff on the stick of Costa for a moment, then he's checked off of it. Hammerquist then as well taken down back behind the net. Centering pass to the blue line, and that one deflected right in front and steered away by, I don't know if it was Costa or Pingree there. But that puck steered to the corner, thankfully, because that shot had some mustard on it. Deking, the Rangers in the corner, back to the blue line. Another shot blocked by Kian Bendico. And back into the low slot. Oh, cross ice pass through the slot, and the Rangers had a player waiting right on the back door there. Just couldn't get their shot away, and it was deflected by Duke. They didn't get a whole lot on it, and Duke makes the save. Hammerquist sends it off the glass and down the ice. 11 seconds left on this penalty kill for the Rams. So far, so good. Stretch pass for the Rangers. And the Rams are now back at even strength. And they send it all the way down the ice. Miller was at the blue line waiting to skate in for it, but because that penalty had just expired, that's an icing call. Nico Miller to take the faceoff. That puck strolls its way right along the crease as Duke looks at it and watches it go to the corner. Picked up by Patterson and sent back in by the Rangers. Now Melnick with it. Makes a couple nifty deeks, and he is through the neutral zone. Gets a long shot off the goal. 18 shots on goal in the first period for the Rangers and only two for the Rams. I expect that stat to be better this period as Miller skates back for it. Makes a clean pick of that puck and a pass to himself off the boards. Miller with wheels, has support from Nick Landy. Landy up. And Landy moving quick to get back and play D as that puck is turned over. Centering pass, Kiko. Kiko Miller moving to the corner for it. Hooked away by a Ranger and then back out, and we are all alone is Pingree. Pingree makes a huge glove save as a 2-on-0 occurred. Tremendous offensive pressure from the Rams. Had their defense pinching in the offensive zone. They got caught. Two Ranger players back. And in on Duke, cross ice pass right through the slot. Duke makes the glove save and flashes it to everybody within eye shot of him just to let him know that he came away with that one. What a save by Pingree. Rams trying to sort their lineage out right now as Melnick steps back on the ice. Rangers take the faceoff, back behind Pingree. Kian Bendico in with the forecheck. Back to the blue line, cross ice pass. And that one just goes to the left of Pingree. That puck looked like it may have gone in. That was odd. From my vantage point. Backhand try right in front of Duke, and he covers up. I think Duke might have had about enough of this for right now. We need to get this puck out of the Ram zone. .437 left in the second here as the Rams prepare to take the faceoff. Rangers win the faceoff. Costa picks the pocket of the Ranger player, and Landy now working for it in the opposite corner, still with the Rangers, and sent back to the corner again. The Rams looking to just clog up the area in front of Duke, it looks like right now, to prevent some of this stuff from getting through. Blue line try, another block by Daniels. That's two blocks in a row by Daniels, and Komrovsky's off to the races, looks to center, and he centers it right onto the stick of a Ranger player. He had support in on the right side, but that pass couldn't connect. Daniels sends it in deep as the Rams make a change. Landy gets a shot off, saved by the Rangers. Komorowski battling for it in the corner. And now Landon Bendico in shot. Daniels saved by Lewis Palmer. Didn't get a whole lot on that shot, but he did get one through.
Well, folks, looks like we're back. All the technical gremlins have been shaken off. So I certainly do apologize for the first period, losing practically everything. But as you can see, the Rams are fighting back from a 2-0 deficit, scored one in the second period, and we're back.
Kept in by Patterson, and back on the stick of a Ranger. Patterson looking to forecheck. Skated out by the Rangers and through center ice. Hammerquist back to defend. Shot goes high and off the glass over the glove of Duke. Hammerquist wheels it around the sideboards. Pass connects with Pico Miller and just rolls off of his tape a little bit, but he's in hard on the forecheck, sends it back behind the net. The ref looks to get out of the way, centering try. And it is back with the Rangers, who send it to the near side here and skated up and through the neutral zone. Hammerquist pokes it back the other way. Culp checking his man from behind. Muratori in to defend. That puck right off of Duke and up into the netting. So we'll have a face-off in the Rams' defensive zone here. Face-off picked up by the Rangers. Shot goes in off the skate of Denis and sent to the corner. Matheny parked right in front of the net along with Pingree just to make sure that that area is taken care of. He goes back to check his man. Centering pass deflected into the corner by Pingree. Great stick save by Duke. And the Rangers skating with it again in the corner. Not a whole lot of forecheck pressure here as the Rangers sort of skate freely with it. I think the Rams may be trying not to get caught up too much in the forecheck pressure in order to be able to defend well. Denis goes after this puck against the boards. And sent over to, this is Landon Bendico. Landon makes a move around his man. He's going to get a shot in on goal from the right wing. Great move by Landon there. Denis sends it back in deep for Steele. Steele looking for it, fighting with his man, loses his stick. Puck's caught up in his feet right now. Steele just trying to free that puck up in a way that it winds up with his teammates right in front. And a shot by Komorowski, steered away by the Rangers goalie. Costa keeps that, almost keeps that puck in onside, but doesn't.
1 minute remaining in the period.
And it looked to me like Steele was back onside there by the time Costa took that puck in, but
almost. He was a step off, unfortunately.
Might have Homer eyes.
Well, it's good to be back, Dustin, that's for sure.
Yeah, did we miss all the second? Where are we?
Well,
I was talking an awful lot, apparently just to myself.
They heard you. It was great. Yeah. But we lost the first period. A little bit of the second.
Well, we're glad to be back where you can see the game at this point, hopefully. And the Rams still in this one. Duke comes out to make a play. Oh, my goodness. That was deflected back into the corner. And
nice.
Off the stick of Duke and up into the air. 45 seconds left in the period here. Landy defending that shot with his legs. Centering try right in front. And the Rams come up with it. 3-on-2 chance here. Oh, and just overskated by Nick Landy, who had Komorowski going up the right wing all by himself. Here's Komorowski again, and he just misses the connection with that. Costa getting into it on the far side boards with number 43 from the Rangers. And that is outrageous that there's no call on that. It is absolutely outrageous that there's no call on that. What a joke. as Blake Komorowski's taken down hard to the ice by just a flying air tackle by one of the Rangers. Just a ridiculous play. Let's go, Blake! And I'm going to give it up for him. I'm sorry if that hurt your ears at home, folks, but Blake is asking us to cheer for him, and we're going to do it. He just took a huge hit for the team, and I am baffled that there was no call on that.
Yeah, it looked like it was a pretty nasty hit.
Some flying acrobatics to go tackle Blake.
Yeah, the Lewis Palmer player looked like he left his feet.
He did.
And that is certainly illegal. 2 seconds left in the second, and there you go.
Thankfully, the Rams are going to get a minute here to take a rest and talk about it, because they're still in this game against a really good Lewis Palmer squad. So this game is one that they can still tie up and even win if they can stay focused and disciplined here. That hit on Komorowski was uncalled for.
It was pretty severe. The puck was still within stick's reach, but yeah, that was a pretty nasty hit. The Lewis Palmer player, he had it lined up, but left his feet, lunged forward, made contact. That definitely should have been called.
Shocked that there was no official's arm in the air after that one, and it looks like Coach Mack having a conversation with the officiating crew about it right now, trying to understand how that wasn't a penalty.
Yeah.
I have the same question. And we'd love to get an explanation from Mac after the game as to why that is.
Yeah, there's definitely a lot more being let go in this game than we're used to.
Yeah.
So hopefully we'll get Coach Adams back and kind of explain what's going on.
Yeah, that'd be great. I'd love to hear from Coach Adams as well, because we saw that elbow to the head right against the near side glass in the first period.
Wasn't called.
That was a non-call against Lewis Palmer as well. And both of those penalties were relatively egregious. You don't necessarily see very often that kind of stuff get let go. I understand a little ticky-tack stuff here and there, but both of those plays were pretty rough. My opinion, should have been called.
And the physicality is definitely ramping up, but a little too much to be out of control. So we'll see how the third period goes with these refs, see what they call, see what they allow. This is going to be an interesting 17 minutes, the last frame of this game, but the Rams have cut the lead in half, making it a 2-1 game coming into the third.
So ice cleaning going on, Gene, and then we'll be back in just a bit.
That's right. We'll be right back, folks. Thanks for everybody coming back, all five of you. And hopefully we'll see a lot more here in the third. Thanks, everybody. Be right back.
All right, folks, welcome back. We're getting ready for the third period here at Monument Ice Rinks in Monument, Colorado, with the Rampart Rams facing off against the Lewis Palmer Rangers. And right now we have with us one of our coach alumni, Alex Adams. Gene, going to chat with Alex for a minute.
Hey, Coach Adams, how's it going? We kind of screwed up with the audio and the technical difficulties in the first period, but we saw that Lewis Palmer scored one goal in that period. Kind of run us through how that first period went, since we've kind of lost everybody there.
Yeah, absolutely. So that first period, we really kind of were still trying to feel out that team. Something we figured out, you know, early in the first was that, you know, they were going to try and do everything they can to control the tempo, but they didn't like being hit. So the moment any of our guys started to hit them was when the tempo started to shift back in our favor. So you could see a lot of that focus was there in the second period to try and get that tempo back, to try and make sure that our guys were hitting. And, you know, a few of those guys came out and they did a really good job. And, you know, when we were hitting, you saw we controlled the momentum. You know, they couldn't break it out. Things were going our way. Right. So this period this third period is all about trying to keep that going, making sure the body contact stays there, making sure that guys just focus on things one shift at a time, making sure they give everything they can for 30 seconds and then change and get the next fresh pair of legs out there.
Yeah, it seemed like the second period they rallied. They scored a goal, keeping the deficit down to one goal. What happened there? What turned things around? What happened between that first intermission, between the first and second period?
Yeah, absolutely. These guys just recommitted to being physical. You know, that goal came from someone being in front of the net, owning in front of the net, the tip screens, rebounds. You know, just making sure that area was really ours was kind of where that first goal came from. And, you know, the momentum started to shift right there. And I think it was pretty clear that period.
So what do you think's going on in the locker room coming into the last frame here?
Right now, the guys are really just focusing and trying to make sure that they take things one shift at a time. You know, really shorten the game. This is the thing Josh has been talking about for years.
Right.
I know all of our alumni listening right now that, you know, this is nothing new to them. But making sure that, you know, they take things one shift at a time, reset, really making sure that their focus is there the moment they step on the ice and they just go 110% until they step back off.
Okay, and where's the leadership coming from? What do you expect out of some of the other players, specifically who?
You know, there's a lot of strong leaders on this team. You know, last period, Sam Culp and Kiko Miller, they did a great job of getting out there and being physical and dictating the tempo. I think, you know, you look for those two to this third period to keep that momentum going. I think a lot of things are going to come from them. But, you know, like I said earlier, there are a ton of great leaders on this team, lots of upperclassmen. You know, there's a number of places for them to look.
Yeah, it seems like the refs are letting a lot go on a lot of these hockey hits that might be a little questionable. What do you think?
You know, I think everyone has a different opinion on that, right? You know, no matter what happens, one team's unhappy. But, you know, these refs, we know one of them used to play for Josh, so we know they're calling a very even game. We're not mad because we don't think, you know, that they're really trying to screw one side or the other. It's a very even game. They're calling things consistently, whether or not we agree with what they're calling.
Right, exactly. All right. Looks like we're about to get started. Good luck in the last frame, Coach.
Thanks.
All right. That was Coach Alex Adams for the Rampart Rams giving us the rundown on the first and second period and what he expects to see in the third. Just about ready for faceoff here. One frame left here for the Rams to tie this thing up and maybe even pull ahead. Go Rams. Miller takes the faceoff and a tussle at center ice there for it. Winds up on the stick of Nick Landy. Landy's centering pass off the skate of a Ranger as Culp works for it. The Rangers skate it back behind their net. Nice hit by Miller to take his man off the puck. Two on one here. Matheny back to defend. And apparently, was that offside?
It looks like it was offsides.
All right, so the Rams catch a break there.
The linesman is pointing to the blue line, so.
With an offside call, as the Rangers were in 2-on-1 and had a good scoring chance. So faceoff just outside the Rams defensive zone here. Kian Bendico taking this one, and he wins that faceoff forward on the stick of Komorowski. Komorowski skating in on the left wing, takes it to the corner. And Bendico pokes that one behind the Rangers net. Poke check by Daniels. Taken back. Daniels tries to handle it again. Can't quite scoop that one up. Back on the stick of Melnick at center ice. Makes a passing attempt for Kian Bendico, and they don't connect. Melnick playing good defense there, just running his man to the outside. And pass back to the point. Shot. In through some traffic, saved by Duke with the pads. Oh, point blank try right in front. And my goodness, Pingree's able to make that save, and the Rams need to ice it to slow things down here for a second. A little frantic in our own zone. Face-off back in the Ram zone, going to be taken by Miller. Miller sends that one to the sideboard and punch back to, oh, cross ice to Culp. Lines up right in on the stick of a Ranger and sent in. Oh my goodness, just too much. Patterson has taken this back. He deeks. Forward off his skate, he pokes it to the center and he's taken down, and we're going to have a Rams power play coming up here, folks, as Patterson is taken down on the near side circle with a trip, puck nowhere near him. So the Rams will get a one-man advantage here for the next 2 minutes.
And that definitely was a valid call. The puck was in the center ice when he got tripped up, so.
Yeah. Yep. That was not a play on the puck in any way, shape, or form.
No. Rams go on a power play here for 2 minutes at 15:21 in the third period.
Take this man advantage and see if we can get something done with
it. Let's do it. Let's even it up.
Kept in at the line by Melnick. Melnick looking for a lane. He doesn't see one here. Gets one in through traffic and right into the gut of the Rangers tendy.
It's like Coach Max giving on-ice advice as things are unfolding. That's good.
That's what you want. You want your coach actively coaching, right? This puck is wheeled around up into the netting, so we'll have another face-off attempt here. That puck seems to be stuck pretty well.
I say leave it. That's
maybe that's the last puck.
I hope it's not the last puck. This is an ice rink for hockey, so.
All right, we found another puck. That one's going to stay up there for right now. Miller takes that face-off, wheeled around to the far point. Shot in.
Whoa.
Nice deke by Miller. Miller makes a move. Cross ice pass to Melnick. Melnick looking for a shot. Traffic in front. Back on the stick of Melnick. Melnick walking the blue line. And sent in just wide. That
Whoa.
Shot had
nice.
Heat on it. This is Miller with it. And back to Melnick. Melnick takes a shot. Another opportunity as Melnick pokes that puck from the defender to keep it in play. But it's picked up by a Ranger. And they're headed north. He makes a deke attempt behind his own feet, and it was a really nice effort, but it just didn't connect. Back, Rams headed back the other way. And 55 seconds left in this penalty. And the Rams looking to break out of the zone. Off the stick of Komorowski and sent down. Coach Matt calling for a forecheck here. Back to the near side board is Komorowski with it. He and his man going to the corner. That puck is cleared out again. It's going to be right down on Duke. Duke passes it over to Costa. Across to Komorowski. Sends it to the board. Daniels picks it up. Drops it off for Costa. Costa coming through the zone with wheels. Gavin looking for a shot.
Now
Gavin Costa goal. It was not a fast one. It was not a laser.
Hard rising shot towards the glove side.
Was on the rise and confused the Rangers goaltender. And this game is tied with 13:31 left in the third, folks. Your Rampart Rams are in this game 2-2.
That was a great power play shot. And hard rising shot, beat the glove. I think the goaltender actually got a piece of it, but it was just too hard. And
yeah, it seemed to wobble over his left shoulder just a little bit.
So great shot. That's exactly what the Rams needed.
Yep.
2-2.
Maybe the Rams realizing that this is a winnable game now.
That's right. There you go.
Patterson attempts to play that puck. It's all the way back in on Pingree. Pingree sends it up the sideboards as Miller's bumped away from the puck. That hadn't quite arrived just yet. All right. Credit to the goal. And Duke picks up the secondary assist via Komrovsky, and finally Costa taking it home. Congratulations to Duke.
Gets
on
a
the
point.
Secondary assist there.
Very nice.
Shot saved by Pingree. Culp overskates a little bit, but he's back on his stick, and he's looking to skate with it. Sends it across ice for Landy. Landy in, sweeps at it, doesn't connect with the puck. And the Rangers send this puck out again. Quickly on
almost
the stick.
Almost, yep.
Of Landon Bendico as he sends it back in deep. Landy with a shot from the near side point.
That's and icing.
This should be an icing call on Lewis Palmer. Great pressure from the Rams here in the third, Gene.
Yeah, they're definitely pouring it on. They were kind of smart in the first period playing a big D game, but they were kind of feeling out this Lewis Palmer team. Like Coach Adam said in the second period, Coach said something, they rallied back together and got that second goal, their first goal, and here we are tied 2-2.
There you go, face-off won by Denis and sent in deep by Steele. Steele back with it, and he whiffs on the puck, and the Rangers will skate it out of the zone. Cross ice to the far side. And that puck tipped way high into the air as the several players convene. And is it a hand pass, Gene, or what's the call there?
I think there's a stoppage in play on the in the Rams' defensive. No, looks like offsides.
Okay.
So, or no.
That's odd. That puck was inside for a while.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
That's a confusing call.
Well, it was either offsides, but it looks like maybe a hand pass, but I don't know why it's coming back in the neutral zone. So
interesting.
Yeah.
Costa gloves it down, sends it forward for Landon Bendico, and fight for the puck at the blue line.
Whoa.
Landon Bendico gets nice and physical with his man. Costa back to retrieve this puck behind his own net. He overskates it, whiffs on the puck, but he is back with it. Gavin Costa headed out of his zone, looking for the connection with Denis off the back end boards.
No, that should not be icing. He beat the puck.
So we have an icing call here. Even though Denis was on time to get that puck.
I guess the ref saw that the puck beat him regardless. It crossed two red lines. And no matter where the player is, it's an automatic dead call for icing.
Okay, so there you have it. Daniels skates it out. Daniels moving, fighting his man off the puck. And the Ranger comes up with it. Komrovsky there to try to keep it in. Kept down and back into the zone by Melnick. And here come the Rangers. Plenty of numbers back for the Rams right now. And a great save by Pingree. Sends it into the corner. That neck off its moorings just a little bit, but Pingree fixes it so as not to stop the play. The refs didn't catch it, so play continues. Saved by Pingree. Back behind the net, go the Rangers, and into the corner. Pass reverses right in front of Duke. Duke makes another save. Melnick can't quite get it passed away. Winds up back in the between the pads of Pingree, and he makes another save. So Duke very sharp here this game.
I think that was a purposeful pass from our Rams player. I didn't see who it was to Duke to stop the play, get a break. So that was actually a pretty smart move.
Gotcha. So he was gently trying to get that back to his own guy to slow things down. Makes sense. So here we have Miller to take the face off again. And the Lewis Palmer player just collapsing on the stick of Miller, nice. Tying him up. Shot in, gloved away as Costa is sent into the boards. Colt clogs up his man. Nice. Miller takes his man off the
nice.
Puck, deked away by Costa, makes a sweet move. Here comes Gavin Costa again down the left wing boards. Looking to be strong on the puck, centers it right in front and
no
defended.
One there.
And here's Muratori, sends it back in. Two good defensive keeps by Muratori as he skates back. And shot goes wide of Duke. Right through the crease. Muratori defending and picking it up against the near side boards here in the corner. The Rangers able to skate away with it. Pass back towards the far side point, sent wide of Duke's stick. Puck bobbles back behind the net again. Culp going after
look
it.
Look up.
Culp looking to get it out of the zone. It's gloved down, and that play is offside. I don't know why it wasn't called as such. That was gloved right down at the blue line and then sent back in with the hand of a Ranger player. Caleb Steele with the puck, deking behind his man, picked up by a Ranger.
Oh.
Landon Bendico loses his feet and goes down, but he is back up and rolling. And Hammerquist is on the run. Aiden into the zone. Far side board down in the corner. The Rams fighting for it. Denis checked from behind and away from the puck. This is Landon Bendico centering.
Oh! Oh!
That is a Rampart Rams goal! Do you believe now, Rams? Do you believe now, Rampart Rams, that you can beat this Lewis Palmer team? Because we absolutely do.
Wow.
8:43 left in the third, and the Rams take a 3-2 lead on a point-blank shot by Mark Denis. Beautiful pass. Denis takes the shot. Top shelf, Rams goal. Leading for the first time in the game in the second half of the third period.
Go, Rampart!
Face off back into the Rangers zone. Sent around the inboards. And forecheck by a very aggressive Blake Komrovsky, doing what he does, fighting for that puck. Sent back to the point, kept in by Melnick. Long shot by Melnick goes wide. Melnick picks it up on the other side.
Oh, bad.
Of the blue line. He's all the way east to west on that play. Very quickly with Sean Melnick. This
offsides.
Play.
Go, go,
up
go!
By Komrovsky and sent forward to Daniels. Daniels dishes it back to Komrovsky. Komrovsky with a shot. Glove down by the Rangers goaltender.
Rams goal scored by number 4, Josh Dennis.
And it is
by number 6, Landon Bendico.
Yeah!
Landon Bendico with his first assist for the Rams tonight.
First game.
Caleb Steele.
Great play by all three of those Rams to get that in. Steele, Landon Bendico to Denis. Denis takes a sweet shot and puts it home for the first Rams lead of the evening. Rams clawing their way back into this one, Gene.
Yes, it looks good. It looks good. That heads-up play.
Denis takes the face-off shot. Off the boards, through the neutral zone, back on the stick of Hammerquist, and here goes Aiden Hammerquist into the zone. He dekes. Two men attempt to take him down, and they cannot stop the hammer. Kept in at the point by Costa. Costa shoots, glove saved by the Rangers.
This is a very good game. Yeah, Duke gets his first point. Landon Bendigo in his first game gets his first point.
Gets his first assist. And
great all-around effort.
My favorite stat is the scoreboard right now.
That's right, exactly. Straightforward. Oh, just over skates.
The skates of Caleb Steele. Steele goes to take his man out. Lays a hard check. again. Coach Mack very active on the bench right now, talking to his boys. This puck picked up by Costa. Costa through the zone. Nice hits move. The breaks shot. Glove down by the Rangers Tendy.
Yeah, this goalie's dropping rebounds left and right.
Yeah, we put somebody in front. This is a breakaway chance. All alone. And you can't blame Pingree for that one. He was all by himself. 1-0, which is not the situation you want to be in when you're leading one with 6:49 left in the game.
Yeah, that was actually a good pass right underneath a Ram player's stick. They were on sides. It was Palmer gets control of the puck, and he was all alone.
So if your goalie's your last man back, you have a problem, and that's exactly what happened there. So this one's now tied.
Ramsman. Scored by number 16, Sam Sorville. Assisted by number 11, Andre Mayer.
Rangers now making cross-ice passes inside the Rams zone and skating with the puck, finally picked up by Melnick. Melnick sends it out and off the stick of a Rangers player. This should not be an icing call, and it's not. Rangers going cross-ice with some really long passes here. Be really good for the Rams to try to clog up those lanes a little bit. Culp with it on his stick. He sends it back out.
That was dangerous.
And here comes Kiko Miller. Miller down the left wing, checked hard from behind, and that's going to be a penalty. And as long as we don't retaliate here, we will see a Rams power play. So do we have a power play here, Coach?
I don't know. It looked like it was a legal hit along the board, so I'm not sure exactly what happened, but the refs, the official down in the corner saw something, and it looks, I don't know, no penalty doors are open. There is a Lewis Palmer player.
I mean, ref definitely had his arm up.
In the box.
I think this is a boarding call, Coach.
I'm not sure.
Miller had
possibly.
His back to the player.
There is a 5-minute major penalty on the board.
There sure is. My goodness. This could be a huge advantage for the Rams.
It could actually be a 5-and-10, depending on how many Lewis Palmer players are in the penalty box. Right now, it's just one. But if it was a contact to the head, it definitely is a 5-and-10. But right now, there's only one Ranger in the box.
Now, ref's having a chat with the Lewis Palmer coaching staff right now, breaking it down, so we'll see what the outcome is here. But right now the Rams have five skaters on the ice, so
yeah,
this will be a power play for the Rams.
Here's the good things: if it is a true major, regardless if it's a 5-and-10, this is a continuing penalty, meaning the Rams can score as much as they can in that 5-minute power play.
Well, we'll hope for that for sure. As many as they can get would be great. Let's rack up a few and take this W home.
So we'll see if, everybody's talking. See, and I know some of these Lewis Palmer kids, they actually played with Keaton and Landon back in their younger days. And so everybody knows each other. It's
Rangers penalty number 43,
here we go.
Owen Henry, 5-minute major for boarding.
And it is indeed a boarding call.
Yes, but there's no technical. So either way, it's a 5-minute major.
And the Lewis Palmer fans don't like it, but maybe they don't know what boarding is. It's a very dangerous play when you have your back to a man and you're up against the boards and he hits you and you go flying into the boards. Rules are made to keep the game as safe as possible. It's a dangerous game and a physical game as it is. Boarding is especially one of those plays that can really get a guy hurt. Hammerquist plays it at the blue line, sends it in. Still fighting for it is Aiden Hammerquist. Puck sent back to the neutral zone off the glove of Costa. Costa across to Daniels. Daniels centers a pass that winds up on the stick of a Ranger, and the Rangers now skating it in shorthanded. So the Rams want to regroup here and recall that they have an extra man advantage. Let's look for the open guy. They can't cover all of them with the numbers that they currently have on the ice. Costa tried to deke through a couple of defenders. He winds up passing it back.
Oh, what was that?
And not sure what the whistle was for.
It looks like a hand pass, so Rams had to control it with a hand down in the Lewis Palmer zone, came back and is called for a stoppage in play for a hand pass.
So 4 minutes and change left on this power play. Not really sure how many seconds exactly because the clock here is pretty beat up. We can't see all the numbers, but four and some seconds. Melnick back behind his own net. Centering pass for Patterson, doesn't connect, and this is going to be an icing call on the Rams. So the Rams really want to take a breath here.
And yeah, they're kind of getting ahead of themselves.
This power play like you did your laptop earlier in this.
That's right. Hopefully they can get it up and running faster than I did.
We want this thing to be clicking before this game's over. This is the opportunity that they absolutely needed to get this thing back in the lead column. Puck sent down into the corner. Melnick to the captain. Captain skating back with it. Back to Melnick. Melnick dekes. Moving through the neutral zone is Sean Melnick. Melnick in onside. And checked by his player. And then Hammerquist. Hammerquist looking. And that puck right through the crease. And kept in onside by Linus Patterson. Great play by Patterson. Oh my goodness, big shot from the right point. Just goes wide there. Great opportunity for the Rams. As Melnick in the corner again working for it. Centering pass. Nobody there. Here comes Culp. Culp sends it in off the body of a Ranger. Miller, Kiko Miller, looking to shoot. Deflected in front of the net by their own player. And Culp sends it back to the point. Back in to the corner for Culp. That puck wheeled around and now on the stick of the Rangers as their center skating forward with it. Shot goes well wide and gloved down by Nick Landy. Cross ice pass to Costa. Costa dekes his man, evades, shot. Puck sitting right in the crease, and again, this goalie giving up rebounds, and the Rams need to put somebody there to pick that puck up and send it back to the net. Another shot. That one deflected. Well away from the net. 2 minutes and change left in this power play for the Rams. Long pass for Kian Bendico, misses his stick.
That was a bad
and
bounce.
It's an icing call on the Rams. They'll come back and face off in their own zone.
Yeah, that comes down all the way down for a face off. So it's kind of hard to tell what that board says. 2 minutes.
So we are facing off in our own zone here as Komorowski. Skating back with it is Hammerquist, back behind his net. The big fella moving with it, dishes it back to Landy. Landy to Bendico, I'm not sure which one yet. Across to Komorowski. Oh, sorry, that was Jackson Daniels, excuse me. I believe. Nope. And back out into the neutral zone as Nick Landy skates back for it. Big pressure. We're going to get a tripping call that happened apparently right in front of the official in the Rams defensive zone, called by the official in the Rangers defensive zone. So somehow 175 feet away, an official saw a penalty that the official standing 2 feet away from it did not see.
Yeah, and apparently there was a tripping call when both players were falling down on the ice. So I thought it was incidental contact. Apparently it was a foul, a tripping call on
Landy
the Rams.
Landy goes to the box for tripping for 2 minutes, and now we have even skaters. Here comes Melnick. Glove save by the Rangers goalie. good attempt by the Rams there and a great glove save by Lewis Palmer.
So it looks like after the Rams power play, well, the power play that the Rams are on expires.
And it's a 2-on-1 here. And Duke makes the save, sends it wide. Lewis Palmer with it again at the point. Skating in his number 11. And that puck goes above the head of Pingree and off the glass. Another puck in on Duke. He waves it away with his stick side glove. Culp overskates his man. And that puck shot in and off the glass again. Rangers skating with the puck back in the end boards. Casso poking at it from his side of the net. Big shot. This one comes through and goes back behind the end boards again. Puck over in the corner.
Looks like Rams' power play is going to end in 10 seconds. Lewis Palmer will have about a 20-second power play.
The refs need to get a hold of this game. This is ridiculous behavior. This Lewis Palmer player, the Rams trying to just simply form a wall around Duke and this Lewis Palmer player shoving Costa in the head.
So it looks like both players are coming off. It's opposing penalties.
I don't think so, Coach.
Yeah, Rams and a Lewis Palmer player went in.
Oh, did they? So Costa in the box as well. So a little bit of ridiculousness here. 1 minute left in this game. Lewis Palmer calls their timeout.
Yep. Opposing penalties in the boxes. 1 minute left in the game, and the score is tied 3-3.
What a game tonight, Jim.
This is, And I think the way it sounds like the coaches.
And that's kind of a bit of a garbage call in my opinion.
Palmer penalty, number 16, Sam Starver, 2 minutes for roughing.
So equal penalties here.
Yeah.
Certainly wasn't equal pushing and shoving over there, but that's all right.
Yeah.
All things shake out as even Steven on that exchange. And the faceoff will be in the Rams zone. Four on four hockey here, folks. For the next minute of this game, centering pass right in front. Picked up by Daniels. Daniels headed the other way. He shoves it in. Komorowski in on the forecheck. Kept in by Melnyk. Melnyk back to Komorowski. And a very late hit on Sean Melnyk.
Yeah, that was way
long
past.
After he had let that puck go.
Yeah.
And no call by these Monument refs. Unbelievable. Saved by Duke. Skated away by Landy. Melnyk has it on his stick again. Melnyk makes a move around. Works to evade his man, powers through. It winds up on the Rangers' stick. I can't believe there was no
12
call
seconds
on that.
Left.
That was.
Yeah. And since this is a regular season game, the game can end in a tie. So it looks like in 1.3 seconds, both teams are leaving this game with a point each. a point each for the season. No, not in regular seeding games. So 1.3 seconds, puck drops, that's pretty much it. So you're right, it could be. Now here is the difference. The coaches can agree to an overtime, but I'm not sure how it's going to go down in the books.
I'm certain we've seen another overtime this season.
Well, we'll see what happens.
Just
yeah. It would be a sudden win situation if it is an overtime period allowed, but if it's going to actually count, the game's just going to end officially with 1 point to each team, and they're just playing for fun. I don't know. We'll see what happens. Here we go.
I'm never mad about bonus hockey.
All right, in case you didn't hear, I guess my mic pack died again. We have bonus hockey tonight on a Friday night from Monument, Colorado, as the Rams and the Rangers are going to go to a five-minute sudden death overtime period here from Monument Ice Arena. So the Rams' first goal wins. Miller in on the forecheck. Rangers wheel it around. Colt pinching to the sideboards. Miller parking it right in front of the Rangers goalie. Rangers are going to skate it out.
Oh,
and a good defensive play by Sean Melnyk.
Yep, tied up his stick.
To disconnect that pass, he did. He lifted the stick of the forward and made sure he couldn't get a shot off. Melnyk tying this puck up. Patterson off the stick of Culp and back into the zone. Miller, again with the forecheck, chases his man behind the net. Tough angle shot right in front, saved by Pingree.
Good defensive play there. Yeah, four Rams protecting Duke. Stops the puck, stops the time. 4:02 left in overtime here, 5-on-5.
So face off in the Rams zone. Wheeled around hard for Daniels and up to Komorowski. Komorowski absolutely tripped at the blue line and no call. I'm just not even surprised at this point. Hammerquist sends it back off the dome of a Rangers player, and it's kept in onside. Hammerquist back again, dumps it to the near side corner. Picked up by a Ranger and checked hard by Komorowski up against the boards, pinching that puck for the battle. Hammerquist comes away with it. Hammerquist through the zone, dumps it in deep, and Daniels gives chase. He looks for a centering pass right behind him, no one there. And that puck in and up off the netting, so we'll have a face-off. This face-off should be in the Lewis Palmer zone.
It is. It looks like the refs elect to drop it in the right circle of the goalie. 3:15 left in overtime. Here we go.
So Miller will take this face-off. What a great game. This winds up back on the stick of Casa, who circles back in his zone, hits the break, steeks his man off the skate of Culp, and right back to Kiko Miller. Miller goes into the corner deep. Centering pass right off the post is Kiko Miller's shot. And the Rangers come back the other way. Casa and Landy defending, deflected right in front of Duke. He waves it away. Landy looks to send that puck out, and he gets picked off. Cross-ice pass. This is Kiko Miller. Miller in by himself. He's defended well. Looks for a centering pass and can't connect with Patterson there. This puck headed back as Casa stays with his man to defend. 2:22 left in the overtime period here as Landy takes it back behind his zone, hits the brakes, reverses, and does it again, freeing things up to skate back behind Pingree. And a centering pass with like nobody home for the Rams will be an icing call. And here comes Kian Bendico, Hammerquist, Melnick, Daniels, and Komorowski are the players on the ice here. Komorowski will take this faceoff. Won by the Rams, Daniels takes it through the neutral zone, pitches it down deep, and it's called icing behind the red line. If he was, that play was close enough to let the boys go. With everything else they haven't called tonight, that seemed a little nitpicky. That coach feels the same way. It sounds like he's hollering from his bench that that was a little silly. Shot in. Glove save by Pingree. Glove save Pingree. Glove save Pingree. And another save by Pingree. That one bounces out. Back off the side of the net. Number six right behind the net. Trying to toss that puck over and off the back of Pingree, it looks like, is the attempt there. And you get a body on this man. Puck right in front. And my goodness, some good defensive work there. This is carried away by Sean Melnick. Melnick has Komorowski with him. Melnick to the outside. He's pushed off the puck.